Sigourney Weaver is on her way out. 6-year-old actor Maestro Harrell is here, and he's going to sing. Oh, little yeah. Jackie Wilson tonight, maybe?
He's bad, man.
Well, we'll see. And Party of Five's Jennifer Love Hewitt. Oh, she's cute. Cute girl. My first guest, starring in a new film with Kevin Kline called The Ice Storm. And next month, she returns to the big screen in Alien Resurrection. Please welcome our buddy, Sigourney Weaver. You look great.
Thank you. Thanks for doing my hair tonight.
That's my favorite hairstyle of all the ones you have.
Oh, good.
That's my favorite one.
Great.
That's very sexy. I like
Thank
that
you
one.
So
it
much.
Looks good. Looks good. How have you been?
I've been great. Great.
You know, I have been watching your career. And, you know, I always go see everything you're in. And it seems like you're playing these incredibly sexy characters all the time. And I'm watching Oprah the other day, and she's talking about how women reach their sexual peak. And I'm thinking, I wonder if that has anything to do with you. Because now you had a stage play recently in
yes.
New York where you played a nymphomaniac.
Yes, I did. Yes, I played a woman named Lulu who had to have sex every 15 minutes.
Every 15 minutes?
Every 15 minutes. So, because I researched the parts, I had to figure out, like, the math of that. That's like 48 guys twice, or is it like 12 guys 8 times a day? It's, I decided it was sort of physically impossible.
Or is it one guy 48? Now, how long did that play last? You must have been exhausted by this. I mean, now you got that matinee and then the late show. I mean, every day, you're like, I mean, your husband, then you bring in your work home with you. I mean, my God, it must, I mean, what kind of...
Actually, it's a very energizing
yeah.
kind of work.
Did you meet with sort of people who have that, I guess you'd call it a problem?
Right.
You know.
I thought of going to one of those, you know, Sex Addicts Anonymous thing,
right.
but... I thought maybe I shouldn't know too much about it because it was a comedy, sort of a
right,
platonic
right.
ideal every 15 minutes. So I thought maybe if I really heard about every 15 minutes, it would sort of make it more of a drama.
You know, it seemed like it. Just the constant changing of clothes would
yes.
take a big...
Why don't... She didn't wear much, so that
oh,
was...
Oh, well, that's so good. The
costume was basically a sheet.
Now how did your... really?
Yeah.
Now, your dad, Pat Weaver, and he seems like a fairly conservative guy and,
yes.
and a classy guy. How did he react to his daughter... playing this every 15 minutes then?
Well, I don't think he knew. I never sent him a script. And he didn't come to the show. I think
no.
that would have been, like, harder to do with your parents there, kind of.
Oh, yeah, it seems like very hard to do with that. You might want to skip that 15
right,
minutes.
Right,
yeah.
right.
How about your husband? He must have enjoyed this role immensely.
No, I think he was very supportive.
Yeah.
and, no, I, I'm going to leave that one alone.
So really wasn't bringing your work home. Or
right,
like that.
Right,
yeah,
right.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mentioned this because in your new movie, The Ice Storm, well, I'll let you describe. Your character is?
Janie Carver, who is sort of, I guess you would say, the town slut.
I think you'd say exactly the town
yeah.
slut. I think. Having seen the film, I would say dead on town slut,
right.
I would say. Yes, yes.
You haven't met everyone in the town. But
No, but I was a pretty good guess. And this seems like a hard character for you, because I have to
yes.
admit, you know, I'm lucky. I see these movies before I know anything about them. I just
right.
get, there's this movie, I don't even know who's in it, but
mm-hmm.
I go, we have some guests coming up, I go see it. I didn't recognize it as you, because you were so hard, this
oh,
character,
oh, yeah?
playing this sort of tough girl, and you had long hair, which I'd never seen
yeah.
you have before, and I kind of
yeah.
went, who is, oh my God, it was
yeah.
you. So it was kind of...
Well, she's. You can see her as hard, but I think what Ang Lee, our director, said was that she just very direct.
Yeah.
No hypocrisy.
I guess you could say that. Now, did you meet with various town sluts to get in for this?
Of
movie?
Course, I.
Did
I,
you go to different towns? I'd like
I
to
do.
Meet the slut, and
I
then
do.
She would come in.
I did. I went up to New Canaan and interviewed all the town sluts. I actually remember New Canaan and this being a very. A sedate place.
Yeah, yeah.
I was not part of the group, I guess, that where the parents went to these key parties. They have this key party, as you know, at the end, where all the...
We should explain what
right,
that is.
Right, the men put their car keys in a bowl, and then everyone sits down. The women get up one by one, and they pick the car keys of the men they want to go home with.
Now, the men they want to go home with, they just pick a key, and they have to go home with that guy. Isn't that what it is?
Yeah, I mean, Yeah, I guess maybe they've, like, researched the keys and know which keys belong. I mean, I would hope so.
But it's like swinging, essentially, right?
It is definitely swinging.
So, and it takes place in the 1970s, which made me laugh because I recognized a lot of those sort of
just the clothes,
the bad clothes, the guys with the big collars.
Yeah. You know, you have like big hair?
You know, I had huge hair when I was.
Instead of my husband.
But I was not a swinger. I was not. You know, I don't even let the valet park my car, so I wouldn't give my keys to anyone. Right. I just stay with my car.
Right.
Now we have a, what is this clip? The clip is what scene?
Oh, okay. I think this is a scene where I'm having an affair. I'm Kevin Kline's neighbor, and we're having a sort of apparently, you know, kind of affair, and. So he comes over for a tryst in the afternoon, and we're in the guest room, and he says, you know, I think my wife suspects something, and he goes on and on and on, because his character is very talky, and I sort of go, uh-huh, and then I say, excuse me, I have to go, and he says, where are you going? And I say, well, you know, birth control, and I leave, and I actually get in the car and drive away, and he's left there in his underwear, sort of running around the house for about an hour. But anyway, this is the scene where he confronts me. He hasn't seen me since. He asks me where I've been.
All right, yeah, let's take a look. Here's the scene from the ice store.
Well, what's all that about? What the hell happened?
A prior engagement overcame me.
What?
Listen, Benjamin Hood, I have obligations that precede your... from before you showed up. I mean, one or two good-natured encounters, that doesn't mean I'm... not just some toy for you. When I remembered some chores I wanted to get done before the party, I just did them, that's all. Because I wanted to get them done before I saw Jimmy.
Jimmy? Jimmy? I'm not sure how to take this. What do you mean, Jimmy? I thought you and your husband had...
How you take it isn't all that interesting to me, Benjamin. Sorry.
Ooh. 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 Well, wonderful
you
reviews.
Take the man's side.
I have never seen movies get this kind of review because these people, their lives are so horribly empty. But it's wonderfully well written, and the dialogue and those sort of 70s references. I mean, these people just kind of and no one really looks like they want to have the affair, which is what I find fascinating. But they just do it.
It's actually there are some very funny scenes in it too, and the kids are great. We have Elijah Wood, Christina Ricci, and Adam Hanbird, and they sort of steal the whole thing. Oh, and Tobey Maguire. I mean, they're just.
Let me ask you about Alien now. This is Alien Resurrection. I assume you. It seems to me, weren't you?
I was dead.
Weren't you dead?
I died.
And what happened now? Apparently, a big bag of money appeared. And... suddenly, it's amazing what medical things can do with a lot of money.
Absolutely.
So you're resurrected.
But besides that, besides the big bag, the script was really incredible. It's Joss Whedon who did Toy Story, and it was very clever, had a way of bringing Ripley back.
Yeah, sexier than the other ones?
It's a little kinky.
Uh-huh, you see what I said? You're going through this phase.
It must be me. We had a French director. I think that was more. And so he,
kinked it up.
Was able to go in that direction.
Yeah, Well, that's great. I'm anxious to see that, too. Yeah. So it's nice seeing you. I know you've got to run.
I know.
So thank you very much. Sigourney Weaver, we'll be right back with Maestro Harrell right after this.